Greetings and salutations, dear viewers. Welcome to another mook-whacking episode of The Anti-Viewer! I say, do any of you know what I love more than random bloodshed and terror? Organized bloodshed and terror, of course! Well, yes, there's them, but I actually mean the Mafia! Oh yes, the world of organized crime has fascinated our collective psyche for generations. What little boy has not once dreamed of becoming a mafiozzi, complete with snappy pinstripe suits, fedora hats, and Tommy guns? And of course, the entertainment industry has exploited the bomb of the Cosa Nostra to the utmost, giving us everything and more on these modern-day Robin Hoods, and, in their eternal ingenuity, Japan has followed in this trend. And so what is the most famous Japanese animation take on the Mafia? Why, nothing less than a putrid, obscene, absolutely nonsensical, fangirl-ridden series that is known simply as Reborn! Now, before we continue, I realize that my opinion will severely antagonize the raving wenches, and I'm officially declaring this a fangirl-free zone. Also, I want to make something absolutely clear to all you Reborn fans that will be outraged by this review. I did, in fact, watch Reborn. And not just 5 or 6 episodes, no! I sat through over 120 episodes of this series, and my editor can attest to it, having suffered through over 70 episodes herself! So before you go accusing me of being a flaming troll, kindly read this disclaimer and everyone will be a lot happier. Ahem. Katekiyoshi Hitman Reborn, or Reborn as it is commonly called, was created in April of 2004 by one Akira Amano and is published in Weekly Shonen Jump. Since its debut, the series has earned much praise and popularity from fans and critics alike, consistently ranking at the top of the charts in Japan and abroad, and ranking as one of the 7th highest selling manga in Japan as of early 2009. All of this is well and good, but I would like to remind everyone that a similar craze has swept the fans before. I speak, of course, of Naruto and its wholly undeserved popularity, a series to which I am convinced Reborn is the successor to. But don't take my word for it. Seeing is believing, as they say. Although in this case it is also intense pain. So let us slap on our fedoras, load our dying will bullets, and do a little drive-by in the world of Reborn! Reborn, much like other Shonen Jump manga, features a wide stable of characters, so I will try to keep the descriptions brief. Although, considering what I have to work with, I may actually have to pad their descriptions, the characters are so generic. The main character is a certain Tsunayoshi Sawada, a normal middle school student living in the small Japanese hamlet of Do You Really Care? He is also the young 10th don of the Vongola family, a fact which he is none too happy about. Everyone calls him Tsuna, and I call him Shinji's Jump Baby. Because he is nothing more than a useless and whiny bitch that does nothing but either lament his fate or try and abandon his responsibilities, such as they are. Allow me to elaborate. For the longest time, Tsuna denies wanting anything to do with his heritage. Even when it puts others in danger, his spinelessness is compounded by the fact that the boy himself is a meek, subservient, and as wishy-washy as a laundromat! Of course, he does eventually grow a pair and starts behaving like a traditional jump hero, but his pathetic crybaby beginnings are enough to leave a long-lasting aftertaste in my mouth. Blah! And next, we have the eponymous character himself, Reborn, who is hands down the best character in this mess. Reborn is an infant hitman working as Tsuna's personal home tutor and trainer in the ways of the Don. The absolute idiocy of that last statement is quickly forgotten when we see that Reborn is funny, entertaining, and a sadistic individual, always taking great pleasure in forcing Tsuna to accomplish many punishing and life-threatening training exercises in order to groom him for his future. He is very much the Master Roshi to Tsuna's Goku, if you'll excuse the comparison to a much better character, and Reborn actually possesses a method to his madness. He is directly responsible for turning Tsuna into a decent main character, a no mean feat to be sure. If there was any justice in this world, then Reborn would have been the main character, and we all would have been a much happier for it! Alright, now we shall take a look at the members of the Vongola family, as well as Tsuna's personal group of wise guys. The first character is Hayato Gokudera. Oh joy. Gokudera fancies himself the second in command of Tsuna's merry band, but I personally think that he would rather get to second base with him than anything else. Ha! I warned you! Anyway, there isn't much to say about Gokudera. He's a Tsunere, he's generic, I hate him, let's move on. Up next, we have Takeshi Yamamoto, one of Tsuna's close friends and the resident ditz of the group. Yamamoto is generally unaware of the goings-on in the plot and tends to think that the entire mafia and life-threatening battles thing is nothing more than a game or a hoax, which, if I think about it, is the ideal coping mechanism for anyone watching this show. Yamamoto, bless his tiny mind, is also an accomplished kendo master, able to deal with almost any threat that family faces, and still living to laugh another day. Despite my spleen, he is actually a likable character, always optimistic and capable of tremendous insight as well, especially in the later arcs. Next is Ryohei Sasagawa, a meat-headed boxing club captain and brother to Tsuna's love interest, who has a penchant for screaming EXTREME! He is harmless enough, although his fighting spirit is sometimes annoying, and very much the powerhouse of Tsuna's cronies, using his fists to tremendous effect. Like Yamamoto, he seems unaware of the Vongola family and of Tsuna's position in it, preferring to just have a good time. And now we have Kyoya Hibari, a vicious and cold-hearted delinquent who rules Tsuna's middle school with an iron fist. Hibari is generally the black sheep of Tsuna's mob, acting on his own and only rarely stepping in to lend a hand. I think he would much rather prefer beating the living crap out of Tsuna rather than offer his aid, something he and I have in common. Of course, in the Jump fashion, Hibari eventually becomes one of Tsuna's henchmen, although maintaining his threatening personality and catchphrase.
Kamikoros.
As a fighter, Hibari is easily the strongest of the group, kicking the crap out of anything that stands in his way and taking great pleasure in it. Me, personally, I have no problem with Hibari. Now them, I have a problem with! And the final member of Tsuna's little group is GAH! What in hell's name is that?! It looks like a mutant love child of a chipmunk, a cow, and a white person from the 70s! Next picture, next picture! Whew, that's going to haunt my nightmares for a long time. Anyway, his name is Lumbo, another child who's capable of using a 10-year bazooka to age himself for about 5 minutes in order to aid Tsuna and his friends, and oh god, I miss logic. Personality-wise, he's a male version of Hina Ichigo from Rose and Maiden, only being useful once he ages himself into a slightly more tolerable character. I am honestly at a loss as to what obscene pit this character was dragged from. Here's hoping that the next character will be slightly less ridiculous. And now we come to the supporting cast, the first of which is... Can someone tell me what the fuck that is? It appears to be a hand grenade painted to resemble a Russian pop-out doll called Ipin! All jokes aside, she isn't that bad. Mostly just getting into antics with a mutant cow child and occasionally popping into her older version. Both are accomplished martial artists who are both useful and fairly entertaining. And now we see Tsuna's love interest, the very beautiful and very ineffectual Kyoko Sasagawa. What the hell was that? Anyway, Kyoko is the female version of Yamamoto and is your classic shonen love interest. Kind, cheerful, and supportive of her friends, but of course completely oblivious to Tsuna's rather humongous crush on her. Oh, isn't it so delightfully generic? The other female associate includes Haru Miura, Tsuna's peppy stalker friend, and the other hapless girl caught up in the madness of a shonen series. Haru is eccentric and deeply smitten with our pussified heroes, and is essentially harmless enough, providing a rather amusing counterpoint to Kyoko's genericness. You know what? Let's just stop here, shall we? The other characters include Bianchi, Gokudera's sister who is as bad a cook as she is in love with Reborn, Futa, a meek little shota who can magically rank people with his book I Hate This Show, Dino, the Don of the Chiarone family, who is rather enjoyable when he appears, and a host of other characters who would act as plot spoilers if I mentioned them. What am I saying? I can't spoil something that doesn't exist!